السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وبعد. حديث نمبر 21 from الأربعين النبوية الإمام النووي رحمه الله يقول عن أبي عمرو وقيل أبي عمرو سفيان بن عبد الله رضي الله عنه قال قلت يا رسول الله قل لي في الإسلام قولا لا أسأل عنه أحدا غيرك. قال قل آمنت بالله ثم استقم. قل آمنت بالله ثم استقم. رواه مسلم. This hadith is a famous hadith, as all of the hadith principles and matters of the deen. It's in the subject of al-istiqama. But here, this companion of the Prophet والسلام, he came and he asked the Prophet والسلام, a very different way of asking, where he said, قل لي في الإسلام. Tell me something in al-Islam, in the deen of al-Islam, not a worldly thing, not anything else, but in the deen of al-Islam. قولاً, a speech or a statement. لا أسأل عنه, I would not ask anyone أحدا غيرك. I would not ask about it anyone other than you, O Prophet of Allah. Very precise question. A question that needs an answer that he doesn't need to ask anyone else about it, or what it means and things like this. Even though the answer that the Prophet ﷺ needs volumes and volumes to not to explain what it means, but to expand on that meaning. Because the Prophet ﷺ gave him in two words the entire deen of Islam and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from a person. He said to him, قل, say amantu billah, ثم استقم. Say amantu billah, say I believe in Allah. Then استقم, the order of al-istiqama. Then be straight, be steadfast, be firm upon the straight path. ثم استقم صراط المستقيم, the straight path. ثم استقم, be on the straight path, be steadfast. The hadith from Muslim. I'm not going to explain in the details that it should be in this hadith. This is not what is meant when we talk about the 40 hadith, but we need to focus on certain points here, which is when he said to him, قل آمنت بالله, say I believe in Allah. What is the meaning of I believe in Allah? Amantu billah. Is it the belief of the deviants? Of course, this is in Islam. Is it the belief of those who are deviant? Is it the belief of the Sufis or the Mu'tazilis? Or, you know, what belief, what kind of belief is it to say amantu billah? Amantu billah, I believe in Allah, which basically the entire subject of al-Iman comes under this category, amantu billah. To believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He is the Lord of the Alameen, to believe in the uluhiyya of Allah, that He is the only one worthy of worship, to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with His names and attributes according to the proper way of believing in it, not the invented and the corrupted ways, to believe in the pillars of al-Iman, in the right way, to believe in the pillars of al-Islam, to believe that al-Iman qawlun wa amal, that al-Iman speech and action, yazid wa yanqus, increases and decreases. This is all part of amantu billah. And the evidence of that is when the Prophet والسلام, said to the wafd of Abd Qais, he asked them, do you know what is the meaning of to believe in Allah? This is something that the Prophet ﷺ, he asked him, أَتَدْرِي مَا الْإِيمَانُ بِاللَّهِ? Do you know what is the meaning of I believe in Allah? And they said, Allah wa Rasulu a'lam. They said, Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knows best. They did not say, Ya O Prophet of Allah, we know what it means to believe in Allah. They didn't say, we believe that, or this is what it means to believe in Allah, that the existence of Allah, that He is the Lord You know, this is such an amazing part of the Hadith. The Hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim and others. This wafd, this delegation that came to the Prophet والسلام, and the Prophet والسلام, you know, they told him that we cannot come to you except in the Ashur al-Hurum, in the sacred months, because they have a war between them and the people of Mudar. So they asked the Prophet ﷺ to order them with something like this. Sahabi asked the Prophet ﷺ. They said, فَمُنَّ بِأَمْرٍ فَصْلٍ. Give us an amr fasl, very precise. نُخْبِرُ بِهِ مَنْ وَرَأَنَا. That we would inform those who are behind us, meaning their people, when they go back to them. وَنَدْخُلُ بِهِ الْجَنَّةِ. And we enter by this order al-Jannah. They asked them about the things that are, you know, specific for them, the things that they make drinks and so on. So the point here in the Hadith, Hadith of Ibn Abbas and Bukhari and Muslim, the Prophet ﷺ said to them, أَمَرَهُمْ بِالْإِيمَانِ بِاللَّهِ وَحْدًا. He said to have al-Iman, the faith in Allah alone. So then he said to them, أَتَدُرُونَ مَا الْإِيمَانُ بِاللَّهِ وَحْدًا. He said to them, do you know what it means? Do you know what al-Iman بِاللَّهِ وَحْدًا? What is al-Iman? To believe in Allah alone. قالوا, they said, Allah wa Rasulu a'lam, Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knows best. He said to them, shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah wa iqamu salat wa ita'u zakah wa siyamu ramadan wa an tu'tu min al-maghnam al-khams. He answered the question of, do you know what does it mean to believe in Allah, with the pillars of al-Islam. The shahadatain, establishing the salah, giving the salah, the zakah, siyam Ramadan. So that shows that amantu billah is not just to believe something in the heart, this is also actions involved in it. So to establish the salah, to pay the zakah, to do what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to do, to stay away from what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade us. This is part of an imanu billah. That's why an iman, the proper belief in an iman is like this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Surah Al-Tawbah, والمؤمنون والمؤمنات بعضهم أولياء بعض يأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر ويقيمون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة ويطيعون الله ورسوله أولئك سيرحمهم الله إن الله عزيز حكيم. Like the believing men and the believing women are both allies to one another. Some of them are allies to one another. They enjoin good and forbid evil, and they establish the salah, they give the zakah, and they obey Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. These are the people that Allah would have mercy upon them. Allah is the Almighty, the Most Merciful. وَعَلَى اللَّهُ مُؤْمِنِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave promises, the believing men and women, جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ, and so on. So this is what it means to amantu billah. Not just the aqeedah or the aspects of the ghayb, but rather as the proper meaning of al-Iman, which is the Iman according to the people of Ahl Sunnah wa Jama'ah, in matters of aqeedah and ibadat and akhlaq and everything. So this is what it means to amantu billah. And they used to understand very well these types of meanings by the other statements of the Prophet ﷺ. So then thumma istaqim. Having the proper understanding of an iman and being established upon this iman and doing these deeds and so on, then thumma istaqim, then be steadfast. Then be straight on that and be firm and do not turn away from it. Do not do it once in a while. Do not back and forth. That's why al-istiqamah is suluk al-sirat al-mustaqim. To take the salat al-mustaqim, which is when we say ihdina al-sirat al-mustaqim, this is what istaqim means. To be upon that salat al-mustaqim, which is basically the deen of al-Islam, min ghayri ta'weej. And istiqama is a straight line, so without bend, without being, you know, bending away or taking it different ways, not to the right, not to the left. And that includes doing all of the obligations and the good deeds and so on, the outward appearance and the inwards, and to leave the sins. Right? And as Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he said, al-istiqama kinayatun ala al-tamassuki bi amri Allah ta'ala fi'lan wa tarkan. Al-istiqama, it means that to hold fast to the orders of Allah. فَعْلًا وَتَرْكًا. To do and to leave. To do the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us, and to leave what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade us. So basically fulfilling the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to be steadfast. And this becomes the way of life of the person. and not to change, and not to change because whatever reasons, because it's difficult times, because of to please others or things like this. This deen that was present at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, to be upon it and not to change and not to twist things and not to do things according to one's desire or to according to the people and so on. And the ulama, when they talked about istiqamah, many different statements. And as Umar radiallahu anhu, he said, "La taruha wa ghayna tha'lam," do not do what the wolves do, you know, being not straightforward in matters of the deen. So this is something that we say in Surah Al-Fatiha. This is Salat al-Mustaqim. If we go through the Quran, we see how many times the Salat al-Mustaqim is mentioned. Allahu yahdi man yashaa ila Salat al-Mustaqim. Inna Allah Rabbi wa Rabbukum fa'buduhu hadha Salat al-Mustaqim. You know, فَقَدْ هُدِيَ وَمَنْ يَعْتَصِمْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ هُدِيَ إِلَى صَلَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Whoever is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guiding has been guided to الصَّلَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. وَلَهَلَيْنَاهُمْ صَلَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ. This is after ordering the believers to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is many, many verses in the Qur'an. وَأَنَّ هَذَا صَلَاطِ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. That this is my straight path. فَاتَّبِعُوا, so follow it, and do not follow the subul or the path. فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ, it will make you disperse away from his sabil, from his path. ذَلِكُمْ وَصَّاكُمْ بِهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ. This is what he had ordered you. And many verses like this. So to be steadfast and to be patient. This life needs for the person to be patient, to be upon what the Prophet ﷺ was upon, and not to be deceived by those who imitate nations before. This is the ways of the hypocrites. They follow the nations before. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us in the Quran many verses to warn us against going according to the nations, those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed because of their sins, because of their disbelief, because of their changing in the religion. Right? And there was even since I mentioned this verse in Surah At-Tawbah, before it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he talked about the munafiqoon, the hypocrites, المنافقون والمنافقات بعضهم من بعض. The hypocrite men and the hypocrite women, they're all to one another, like also allies to another. But what do they do? يأمرون بالمنكر ونهون عن المعروف. They enjoin evil and they forbid goodness, right? And then after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned right after this verse that كالذين من قبلكم, as those who before you, كانوا أشد منكم قوة. They used to be stronger than you, وَأَكْثَرَ أَمْوَالًا أَوْلَادًا, and having more wealth and more children. فَاسْتَمْتَعُوا بِخَلَاقِهِمْ, they enjoyed their خَلَاق. خَلَاق, if you look at it literally, it means their worldly enjoyment. الحسن البصري رحمه الله, he said their deen. They enjoyed their deen, their way of life, like you enjoyed your deen, and so on. How this is in the context of hypocrisy, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then after that mentioned that he destroyed them, and the people of Nuh and Ad and Thamud and Lut, Mu'tafikat, all of that is mentioned in the next verse also, that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed them. But the point here is they enjoyed their religion, they enjoyed following their desire, they enjoyed whatever they enjoyed, and how this is related to the hypocrites, those who are among the Muslims. And they look like the Muslims and they act like the Muslims, but they're upon deviation, whether it's major one to be disbelievers and they're just pretending to be otherwise. But they followed the ways of others and they enjoyed what they were doing and things like this. So to be careful of all of these things and to be steadfast on how the deen was at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, and to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to hold fast to this. فَاسْتَمْسِكْ بِالَّذِي أُوحِيَ إِلَيْكَ إِنَّكَ عَلَى صَرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ. فَاسْتَمْسِكْ, hold fast very strongly to what has been revealed to you, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. إِنَّكَ عَلَى صَرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ, indeed you are on a straight path. And this is how to follow the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, to be also upon the straight path. And to be consistent in one's actions, in the obedience to Allah. Prophet ﷺ, when in another hadith he said istaqim, right? Istaqimu, that means be steadfast, and the hadith is reported by Imam Ahmad and others. Istaqimu wa ni'imma in istaqamtu, and great it is if you are straight, if you are steadfast on the straight path. And then right after that, he said, وَخَيْرِ أَعْمَالِكُمُ الصَّلَاةِ, and the best of your deeds is the salah. وَلَنْ يُحَافِظْ عَلْ وُضُوءِ إِلَّا مُؤْمِنِ, and no one would guard his wudu, always be in state of wudu except a believer. So this is one of the ways to be steadfast. Try your best to be always in wudu. And before that is to, the best of your actions is the salah, to guard the salah, to make sure that the salah is not compromised or undermined. And he said, alayhi salatu wassalam, to someone, استقم وتحسن خلقك, be steadfast and have good manners, not once in a while, not when it's, when you feel good and you have in a good mood, you have good manners. But, you know, be steadfast. And with regards to the tongue, as the hadith in إِذَا أَصْبَحَ ابْنُ آدَمَ فَإِنَّ الْأَعْضَاءَ تُكَفِّرُ الْلِسَانِ, if the son of Adam wakes up in the morning, the different parts of the body, تُكَفِّر, that means becomes humbled to the tongue. You know, different parts of the body would be humbled to the tongue, and they would say to the tongue, يَتَّقِ اللَّهَ فِينَا, fear Allah in us, فَإِنَّكَ إِنْ إِسْتَقَمْتَ إِسْتَقَمْنَا, if you're straight, if you're steadfast, we will be steadfast, وَإِنْ يَعْوَجَجْتَ إِنْ يَعْوَجَجْنَا, and if you bend, we will be bent too. So the tongue is leading the body, so a person watching what he's saying and making sure that his tongue is busy with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, enjoying good and forbidding evil and so on. And again, many ahadith and the salat that the Prophet ﷺ gave as an example. And to be steadfast in seeking knowledge, to be steadfast in applying the knowledge that we are upon, and to be, seeking rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And many ahadith would say, alayka bi such and such. You know, alayka bi taqwallah. Be upon taqwallah. Alaykum bi sunnati. You know, and the Prophet said, مَا يَعْشْ مِنْكُمْ فَسَارَ اخْتِلَافٍ كَثِيرًا, whoever live among you, you'd find many differences. فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّةِ, that's istakamah. عَلَيْكُمْ, that means stay upon. Do not leave this. فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِسُنَّةِ, stay upon my sunnah, my way. وَسُنَّةِ الْخُلَفَاءِ الرَّاشِدِينَ الْمَهْدِينَ مِنْ بَعْدِ, and the sunnah and the way of the rightly guided khalifa after me. عَضُّ عَلَيْهَا بِالنَّوَاجِرِ, bite on it with the mortar teeth. عَبْدُ عَلَيْهُ وَإِيَّكُمْ وَحْدَثَاتِ الْأُمُورِ, and be warned against the newly invented matters, فَإِنَّ كُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ كُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. The Prophet ﷺ would even, ask the companions, رضي الله عنهم, the Prophet ﷺ, he asked the Prophet, he made hijrah from Mecca to Al-Madina, and then he went to Sham and Misr, رضي الله عنه, and he stayed Unais, Abdullah ibn Unais radiallahu anhu. He said, O Messenger of Allah, hadithni bi'amal, O Prophet of Allah, tell me something that I will be steadfast upon and I will do it. He said to him, alayhi salatu wasalam, alayka bil hijrah fa innahu la mithlala, be upon al hijrah because nothing is the like of it. You know, to keep him steadfast in his hijrah, that he made hijrah for the sake of Allah, to keep it in such a way, even though, Mecca becomes a place of Islam and so on. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be steadfast on his deen and to be upon the sunnah of the Prophet and to be steadfast on the good deeds that we do and the thing, and to guide us to do good deeds till we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, till the moment of death, when the angels will give the glad tidings to the person when he was steadfast on the deen of Allah. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ أَلَّا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.